Hey guys, welcome to another Project Untethered video. Today's video is going to be all about van life job ideas. We're going to look at 10 different ways to make money during van life, including some of the van living jobs that we do to make money on the road. If you want even more ideas for making money during van life or in travel in general, make sure to check out the link in the description below. I have a post of over 100 different ideas of ways you can make money traveling. If you haven't already, subscribe to this channel to get more van life tip videos and digital nomad life videos. Let's get started. Alright guys, now van life can be pretty cheap as it is, even if you're not working. If you haven't seen it already, we have our van life budget video up here. But if you're doing van life full time, you may want to find different ways to earn money and top up your savings account while you're on the road. A lot of these jobs for van life require an internet connection, which can sometimes be hard on the road. We use the WeBoost cell phone booster and it's helped us a lot. I'll link to that in the description below, but it's not perfect. That's why in addition to the internet jobs on this list, I'm also gonna include some other jobs that don't require internet. Alrighty, let's get started with number one. That sun is hot. All right guys, number one is a virtual assistant. A virtual assistant, or sometimes referred to as a VA, is just like it sounds. You're basically someone's assistant and you help them take care of different digital tasks. This could be handling their social media account, it could be doing their Pinterest, keyword research for their blog, doing data entry, managing their email, managing other freelance that they're working with. There's really tons of things that you can do digitally as an assistant. The good news is you might not even have to learn any new skills to be able to become a virtual assistant. If you know how to work Google Documents and know how to organize emails and use an Excel spreadsheet, you're off to a good start. Now, obviously, you'll get paid more if you have specialized skills like specialized keyword research or Google Ads skills or other things like that. But to get started, there's a lot of business owners out there who just need help with the basics. You can do this full time, you can do this part time, but you will need to have to stay connected some of the time, so that can be an issue for some people. These virtual assistant jobs are becoming more and more popular and they're pretty easy to find. You can just basically go to any old job search site like Monster or Indeed, or there's some other specific ones for remote work. Type in virtual assistant and you should have a lot of options. All right guys, number two is freelance writing. And this is actually how I earn the bulk of my income as we're traveling around the world and around the US. And there's two common misconceptions when it comes to freelance writers. The first is you have to be some amazing writer, but really if that was true, I definitely wouldn't be able to do it. I'd say I'm mediocre at best. The second is that freelance writers get paid horribly and are all fighting for super cheap jobs on Upwork and it's impossible to pay the bills. Now that is true in some cases, but if you know what you're doing and you know how to market yourself, that shouldn't happen. Now there's two main routes when it comes to freelance writing and I've done both of them. The first is called content writing and that is writing things like blog posts and other informational articles or other informational material for different businesses. These jobs are usually easier to get and better for beginners. To get started with content writing, I'll link up my favorite course in the description below. The second freelance writing option is copywriting, and copywriting is a little bit different because you are writing different material and your intent is to sell something. And so obviously this is more valuable to businesses because you're directly earning them money with the words that you write. And if you're able to earn a business a lot of money, they're able to pay you a lot of money. When I first started, I knew nothing at all about copywriting. I just read a couple books, but the course that really helped me learn and drill it down into my mind, that course opens up 4 times per year. I'll put the link down below. And if it's not open right now, I highly suggest at least getting on the wait list. Because if copywriting is something you want to do, you won't want to miss this course. And guys, you can start these things without spending money on expensive courses. I actually put together a quick free email course on how to get started with content writing. If you're looking for how to make money on the road for van life, this is a really good option because you don't need to be connected all the time. A lot of times I'll just get my assignments, open up a bunch of tabs in Google, and then we can go camp anywhere, and I don't need internet. I can just write it in Google Docs offline. Number three on the list is what most people think about when they imagine how van lifers make money, and that is to be a famous influencer, either a YouTube star or an Instagrammer with tons of followers, or to have some big van life blog and be sponsored by a bunch of different companies. This does happen, guys, and if it's something that interests you, you should look into it, but it's not as easy as it looks. By scrolling through an influencer's Instagram feed or watching their YouTube videos, it might look like they have this perfect, amazing life, but really, when your travel becomes your work, sometimes it makes travel less fun because you're always worried about getting the perfect shot or taking the perfect video or carrying around all your equipment. And so sometimes it's just hard to relax and enjoy. That said, if you put in the hard work, there's a lot of different ways you can earn as an influencer. You can earn through affiliate commissions by promoting other people's products. You can earn in advertising. You can create your own products. You can use your reach to find clients for freelance work or start another business. Basically, when you have a lot of people who follow you who are interested in the things you're doing, there's a lot of different ways you can monetize that following. But let me ask you guys, what do you think? Would you like to be a famous van life influencer or travel influencer? How do you think the life really is like? Leave me a comment below and let me know what you think. Alrighty, number four on the list is to become a blogger. Now, as you know, I have the Project Untethered blog, which is an amazing blog if you haven't checked it out yet. And let me tell you, making that blog has taken me a long time and a lot of work, and I honestly haven't earned that much from it. It's just starting to earn money as we speak after almost 2 years of work, but let me tell you something. I enjoy working on that blog. It's fun. It doesn't even feel like work to me. And when it comes to blogging, it's not always about direct income, because sometimes when you start a blog and you learn all the different things you need to learn to have a website, it opens up other opportunities that otherwise you wouldn't have had. For example, I've even landed copywriting clients just because I had a blog. After I got hired, my client told me that there were many different applicants, probably many that were more qualified than me. But since he saw that I had a blog, he knew that I must have different internet skills, and so he hired me on the spot. Also, once your blog starts to grow, you can leverage that for a bunch of cool free stuff. For example, if we started writing a tons of stuff about van life on Project Untethered, and we had tons of van lifers reading our stuff, then different companies might start sending us free van life gear to use and promote on our blog. Another example is my buddy Sean Ogle over at Location Rebel. He owns a golfing website. His golf website has blown up, and now there's super fancy private golf courses all around the world that invite him to come golf at their courses. So while it is possible to earn a full-time income blogging, it is very hard, but also there are other perks to having a blog. Number five on the list is a job that does not require internet access, and that's because it's an in-person job. Now, we've met several different people on the road so far who work different seasonal and temporary jobs as they're going. So they'll travel for a few months, and then when they get tired of traveling, they'll stop somewhere and work and save up money so they can leave traveling again. This can be really sweet if you have a skill or a special hobby that you really enjoy. For example, a couple of guys we met are ski instructors during the winter, and they save up their money, and then in the summer they go off and do a van life. Or other people, they're rock climbing instructors or surfing instructors, and they just save up their money for a while, and then they can go and do van life and not have to worry about staying connected to the internet, which gives you a lot more flexibility when you're traveling. This is a great option if you're the kind of person who likes to work hard and play hard, because you can work hard and save money for a couple months and then play hard and travel all over the place and not have to worry about money. Number six on the list is just a normal remote job. With everything that's going on right now in the world, many companies have realized that remote work is a lot more feasible than they thought before, and they're a lot more flexible to allowing their employees work remotely. So if you want to make money while living in a van and traveling around the US or the world, you might be able to just negotiate with your boss and keep the job that you have right now. If there are parts to your job that require you to go in person, maybe you can negotiate and have someone else do it and just take a little bit less pay. That said, if there is no chance that you'll be able to take your job on the road, you might just have to find another new remote job. The good news is, these aren't very hard to find. As I mentioned before, you can find them on the big, huge job sites like Indeed and Monster, and usually there's an option to filter your search for remote. Another two places that I like to look for remote jobs are FlexJobs, which I'll link to below, and also an email newsletter called Dynamite Jobs, where every so often they'll send you a list of all these different companies who are hiring remote workers. When I first started this whole online work thing, that's actually where I found one of my very first jobs. The seventh way to make money living in a van is to work online as a teacher. Now, you can really teach anything that people are willing to pay for, but the most common one is an English teacher. There are millions of people all around the world who would love to learn English, and if English is your first language, that means you have a skill that they are willing to pay for. The trick is learning how to become a good teacher and then finding a teaching job. To learn to become a good teacher, you'll want to take a TEFL course. That's T-E-F-L, and it stands for Teaching English as a Foreign Language. Now, there are many different TEFL courses out there, and some of them are definitely better than others. Some of them are almost downright scams. The one that I took, they have online classes and also in-person classes, so you can choose whatever works best for you. As far as finding jobs go, one of the most popular ways to teach English online is to Chinese kids. There are a bunch of different programs out there that hire TEFL certified English teachers to teach little Chinese kids, and they actually pay pretty well. Not only do they pay pretty well, but it's also usually a pretty flexible job where you can kind of set your own schedule. All right, number eight on the list is another job that you don't need an internet connection for, and it's also another job that we use to supplement our income as we're traveling around, and that is to be a landlord. If you've been following my blog at all, you know that we have our own apartment down in Colombia. And so while we're traveling here in the US, we're actually renting out our apartment on Airbnb. The rent we receive not only pays off our mortgage, but it also gives us an extra couple hundred dollars per month for spending money. I also did this way back on my first backpacking trip to South America. And that time I just rented out my bedroom to one of my friends for $300 or $400 per month. If you have the space, there's really no sense in wasting it while you're traveling around in your van. Number nine is another one you can do without an internet connection, and that is to become a mobile entrepreneur. What I mean by this is starting your own little in-person side business as you're traveling. For example, you could teach people yoga, you could run exercise classes in campgrounds that you're staying on. Diane and I also once have been asked to give salsa dancing classes. You could become a camp barber. Seriously guys, you'd be surprised how many times I've let random travelers buzz their hair with my clippers. Now, you're probably not going to get rich doing any of these services, but it may help offset the cost of gas or food or other van life expenses. The only thing to note here is that if you do this, you'll have to camp in places where there are other people. As you can see right now, we're the only people around here, so this business probably wouldn't work for us right here. But if you're staying around national parks and other places that are more popular, you'll have a lot more opportunities to meet different people. All right, number 10, the last one on our list, besides a bonus one I'm about to give you. But number 10 is to become a consultant. Now you may think, oh, I don't have any skills to become a consultant. I don't know anything about digital marketing consulting or legal consulting or business consulting, but really you can become a consultant about pretty much anything. If you have knowledge in your head that other people want to know about, you can charge people for that knowledge. For example, we met some awesome other van lifers, and they run a holistic healthcare consulting business as they're traveling around in their van. So basically our friend just takes calls to these people and gives them advice on holistic medicine practices. She just learned some skills that help people, and now she charges for it. All right, and now for the bonus, and that is to get house sitting jobs. Now, if you're gonna do van life full time, chances are after a while you're gonna get tired of living in a small cramped space and cooking in a small little kitchen and having to find water and gas and showers and where to sleep every day. It gets tiring. So every once in a while, you probably just want to post up and relax somewhere. One of the best and cheapest ways we found to do this is to do house sitting, where basically you find people who are going on vacation or leaving, and they need someone to take care of their pets while you're gone. So they get a free person to take care of their pets, and you get a free place to stay. We actually did a video on how to land your first house sitting job, and I'll link to that up here. But basically, you have to pay to get access to a house sitting platform, and then from there you get matched up and you apply for different house sitting jobs. And even if you land only one job per year, that will more than pay for your annual subscription to these house sitting sites. For example, Trusted House Sitters, which is the one we use, and I'll link to that one. During our first house sit, we stayed for over a week in a neighborhood that on Airbnb would cost over $100 a night to stay in. So we saved a lot of money on that deal. Plus, when you decide to take a break from van life and do house sitting for a couple days or a couple weeks, you'll be able to get into a routine and be more productive on your other work and save money doing your other van life jobs. All right, guys, that's it for today. I hope you got some good ideas. If you like this video, you will also like our video on van life expectations versus realities. It's a hoot. If you haven't started van life yet, you need to see this. And if you have started van life, I think you'll get a good giggle from it. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more van life and digital nomad tips videos. If you like this video, give me a big thumbs up. Leave me a comment below saying, Mitch, you're awesome, or Mitch, you suck. And I will see you in the next video.